When I joined the business, when I joined Godrej in 1975, at that time, the way that the company was organized, I had learned from my father. And basically, every day when we went to work, I used to sit with him and do everything with him and go move around the factories. Whatever he did, I was with him from morning to night. I did that for 3 years. And I think that what I learned about the products we make, about how he dealt with people, about how, you know, he essentially interacted with everyone. Really, the thing that struck me from those days was that everybody that he worked with personally had a personal stake in making sure that whatever was required, whatever was wanted of that person in terms of production, quality, sales, etc., was always done. So it was always that personal involvement. It was a very emotional and personal involvement. And when I had to take over from my father, of course I learned all that, but I found that I just couldn't, that was not something that was my style. And my father used to, every day he used to spend at least 3 to 4 hours in the factory. He used to go around the factory because that was his first love. He really wanted to be there, he wanted to talk to the workers, he wanted to talk to the supervisors, he wanted to talk to the managers. That was his style. And through that, he got an enormous amount done. When I took over, I found that I was being, and somehow he had the knack of managing the paperwork in the factory without spending much time on it. And I found that I was just getting inundated with work in the office, and I could never get out. And so I started spending a lot of time basically with the managers and the unions and the workers in small groups, trying to understand what it is that they were going to change, how are they going to change, because now they have to deal with me, they didn't have to deal with my father, it was totally different. And what came through with them was that, look, if you don't come to the factory every day and be seen, then people will not realize that this is something important. And that's something that really struck me. And I have, ever since then, I think I changed the style in which I worked, the way my father worked for a long time. And I think that this is something I think very much in a family business, that when generations change, the way that you get a response from people in the company is more by being much personally involved. And somehow I have never been able to repeat that same. So what have we done? What have I done? That's very different. I think one significant difference is that we've had, till 1972, we had very turbulent and very violent labor relations. It was quite traumatic for me personally. My family went through an enormous amount at that time. But I think that one thing that I learned through working with my father was that you had to really spend a lot of time just sitting and talking and listening to the union, to the workers, to the managers. And that's really what I started doing. And this is where the transformation really started in terms of being able to try and explain that although we were close to a 100-year-old company with many, many businesses and many different and very diverse businesses, that the most important thing was to understand productivity and quality. Of course, we had a long history of involvement in being a quality oriented company. But I think that the moment we changed our outlook to competition in India, the type of quality requirements that were there was so much different. So to understand what productivity is, to understand what quality is, I think those types of benchmarks that we had, we went through a lot of transformation. We tried to understand what is Six Sigma, all the different ways of working, etc., the quality tools. But the only thing that seems to have worked is when you form these small group activities and get people to understand what it is you're trying to do. And we have this Japanese gentleman who has been involved with us on the manufacturing side for many years. And the first time he came to see me, and he sort of went around the company and said, well, you know, if you were in Japan with so much space and so many people, your turnover would be many times what it is today. Have you ever thought of that? And don't you think that you can produce, you know, maybe four or five times what you're making today with about one-third or one-fourth the number of people that you have and release all the space that you have? And that's what really, I think, started us thinking about what we had to do different. And when I personally started getting involved in these projects, which had to make our products competitive, I think my main transformation and contribution was basically to make sure that at the grassroots level, at the factory floor level, that people started to understand what was required of us in terms of cost, productivity, quality, new products, etc. And these are the things that I think have really sort of stood us in good form through the years. And the challenges that I see going forward now are essentially, you know, that an old company with a lot of welfare, a lot of housing and schooling and welfare activities, how do we currently, none of these activities sort of pay for themselves. They're all very much a part of our overhead cost. How do we convert this into something productive? And so over the years, we've brought up, through a lot of discussion with our union and workers, we've been able to make them understand that we cannot go on with welfare, that you know, everything that the company provides, whether it's schooling, housing, or medical, has to be paid for. There is a huge change in attitude in people now trying to understand and pay for things that they never used to pay for. And this is really what has made that change in the people. Today, whenever we have a meeting with our workers, with our unions, I don't have to say very much. The unions themselves, they talk about quality, they talk about productivity, they talk about safety. They do all the talking. In fact, the amazing thing is that our unions are much more, the workers and the unions are actually much more aware of what is required to be done in terms of competitiveness compared to even supervisors and managers, etc. So I think it's this type of constant journey and interaction that allows that grassroots involvement and a deep sort of sense of belonging. And so in a way, you come back full circle. You know, the type of direct one-to-one relationship that many of these people had with my father, I mean, that was what it was. Now, the difference is that it comes from them directly. They realize, they themselves understand, they want to do it that way. And that is what, this is the transformation I see that has really made a difference. So whether it's downscaling workforces or giving out space in the premises, or you know, whatever we have to do to be competitive and be profitable, I think the buy-in now has become so high. So I think this is really what I have done and the company has done for the last 25 years since I joined the business, in being able to get people now in the organization to do and to say and do what I would otherwise have to ask them to constantly say and do. And that has been a great deal of satisfaction. I think what our workers especially find is that when the encouragement on technical developments, on technical challenges, we do some very high-tech work for our space program and our defense services. And the real challenges come when the workers on the shop floor themselves now feel that type of empowerment, that they can find solutions to critical problems which engineers and consultants in technical universities, etc., have very rarely been able to be, you know, find those solutions. So it's that practical. So this is what one has to constantly encourage. It's the people at every level in the organization contributing in every way that really transforms. So this is essentially, you know, in a nutshell, what I wanted to mention here today. Thank you.